When I examine the Star Wars franchise, specifically the Skywalker saga, I gotta say, when I think of a Star Wars movie, the things that I really do love about them are the lightsaber duels, the space battles, the land battles, and of course the quests and adventures that the heroes and the villains go on in these stories. This is Mike Zero. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, one thing that a lot of people, including myself, am really looking forward to seeing in this movie are, of course, the action sequences that J.J. Abrams will be implementing in this story that is going to be something quite else than we have ever seen before in the sequel trilogy, that of course being The Force Awakens and The Last Jedi so far. Now, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film when it comes to some of the set leaks, the set designs, the concept art and storyboard descriptions, etc., one of which has all to do with one of the major action sequences involving Rey and Kylo Ren. Specifically, a description of Rey inside of an E-Wing, performing barrel rolls and heading toward one of the First Order finalizers. It's described that her starfighter shoots off missiles that head toward the finalizer's bridge, causing a massive explosion with the destroyer falling down toward the surface of the green world and burning into the atmosphere. The next goes over Kylo Ren in his new TIE fighter design, releasing what appears to be something similar to seismic charges, tearing a resistance cruiser into two halves, followed by a sequence involving Kylo firing his blasters at and destroying what's said to be two K-Wings. Lastly, a sequence involving Rey inside of her starfighter, where her wing appears to be damaged with sparks as three TIE fighters are behind her firing. It's described that R2 is doing repairs and helping Rey regulate the ship. So I want to go over a couple of parts about this. Now, this obviously takes place within the third act of the movie for one of the major space battle sequences in Episode 9. So first things first, the thing that really does impress me is the sequence involving Kylo Ren in his new TIE fighter design that is going to have these weapons that are very similar to that of seismic charges. I know a lot of Star Wars fans out there love the sound of seismic charges from Episode 2, right? Now, that whole entire battle involving Obi-Wan and, of course, Jango, it was one of the best sequences in, of course, the prequel trilogy in space. So now we're getting something similar in a sense to that, where Kylo Ren's new TIE design is actually able to release these charges that are similar to the seismic charges from the prequel trilogy, splitting a resistance cruiser into two halves. Now you can really see that JJ is really trying very hard to take a lot of elements from the prequels and basically insert it into this movie and do something new. If you look at Episode 2, basically asteroids, rocks, right? Space rocks were actually being split into two pieces, or maybe even multiple pieces. Now it's going to be actual ships by use of these new types of seismic charges released by Kylo Ren's new TIE fighter design. Now, the next thing that I really do want to go over is, of course, Rey in her E-Wing. Alright, now we do know that E-Wings and K-Wings are going to be a part of this story. I'll get back to K-Wings a little bit later. So, E-Wings, alright? Rey is actually performing barrel rolls and heading toward one of the First Order finalizers. Now, a lot of people are starting to wonder, why would she have her own starfighter in this movie if she has the Millennium Falcon? The thing is, I believe that since a lot of scenes were shot involving Lando Calrissian inside the cockpit of the Falcon, I think it's pretty safe to say that Lando's gonna take the Falcon and claim it as his own once more, while Rey now gets a new starfighter at the end of Episode 9, giving us a little bit of a callback to what Luke had with his X-Wing in, of course, the original trilogy. If you think about it, Rey still does not have her own starfighter in the sequel trilogy. So far, you know, she's only had the Millennium Falcon, something of which that is not really her. It's really Han Solo's, it's really Lando Calrissian's, and of course among others. So the next thing that I do want to go over is how her actual E-Wing design is said to be slightly damaged, with R2-D2 performing repairs. Now this to me is another callback to Star Wars A New Hope, where we do know that, you know, Luke Skywalker gets shot at, and R2-D2 is fixing the wing, and he's doing some repairs. It's really bringing me back to the original trilogy, especially in A New Hope, of course, with Luke Skywalker in the trench run. So you can really see that JJ wants to implement a lot of these parallels from not only the prequels, but also the originals in their own unique ways. Now, the last thing that I do want to go over is this sequence that involves Kylo Ren in his new TIE design destroying two K-Wings, alright, using his blasters. Now, K-Wings, I'm not quite sure if they're canon. I know that they were a thing in Legends, if I'm not mistaken, but K-Wings, They kind of look like an E-Wing. They're larger. They have more wings, I believe. They span out more. It's a very interesting and unique design from what I can recall. I haven't seen them for a very long time. But you can tell that JJ really wants to put in new ship designs in this movie. You know, kind of like with Rogue One, we got new starfighter designs, right? Now in Episode 9, that's exactly what JJ is going to be doing. We're going to be getting the E-Wings, we're going to be getting K-Wings, new TIE fighter designs. I mean, it's going to be quite surprising to see other ships than just X-Wings and, you know, TIE fighters and A-Wings. So anyways, guys, what do you think about this major space battle sequence involving Kylo, Rey, and of course these new starfighter designs entering into the Star Wars franchise on the big screen? I think that the thing that really does interest me the most is of course Kylo using these seismic-like charges, splitting the Resistance cruiser into two halves. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below, let me know what you think about all of this in the comments, and if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.